Actions of Iran have shocked the civilized world.
There's a Hollywood story of the Iranian hostage crisis that we all know from a movie called Argo that came out last year. It tells the story of a CIA mission to sneak six American diplomats who had fled the embassy out of Iran. The movie depicts a hostile Iranian government in public, whipped into supporting the hostage crisis and determined to do harm to Americans. That story won an Oscar for Best Picture. But there's another story about this hostage crisis that's rarely told, one that's perfect for Hollywood too, if it weren't for the fact that it implicates a major U.S. political party and a former presidential administration in a conspiracy to use American hostages as a bargaining chip to win an election. Earlier this year, an article was published in the Christian Science Monitor. It slammed the movie Argo, saying that by falsifying, misrepresenting, and taking critical facts out of context, the Academy Award-winning film Argo delivers a pro-CIA message at the cost of the Iranian people and history. The article then goes on to note that the movie misrepresents the Iranian government's stand in regard to hostage taking. It also completely misrepresents Iranians by portraying us as irrational people consumed by aggressive emotion. And then the first election post-revolution, an election that took place during the hostage crisis, 96% of votes in that election were given to candidates who were against the hostage taking. So then why, with all of this support for releasing the hostages, did the crisis last so long? Well, here comes the bombshell allegation. Ayatollah Khomeini and Ronald Reagan had organized a clandestine negotiation, later known as the October Surprise, which prevented the attempts by then U.S. President Jimmy Carter to free the hostages before the 1980 U.S. presidential election took place. The fact that they were not released tipped the results of the election in favor of Reagan. And sure enough, the hostages were released the day Reagan was sworn in. Now, this is a pretty explosive charge, and you're probably thinking it came from some crackpot, right? Well, no. The man who wrote this article, who's making this claim, is none other than the former president of Iran himself, Abulhassan Banisadr, the very first president of the Islamic Republic of Iran, the man who served during the hostage crisis. Banisadr adds, two of my advisors were executed by Khomeini's regime because they had become aware of this secret relationship between Khomeini, his son Ahmad, the Islamic Republican Party, and the Reagan administration. As part of the deal keeping the hostages longer, it's alleged the Reagan team promised Iran weapons, which would be funneled in via Israel, as well as the unfreezing of certain Iranian assets in U.S. banks. This wasn't the first time Banisadr made this claim either. In 1992, he in fact wrote a letter to a House of Representatives task force investigating allegations that the Reagan team conspired to keep the hostages longer. That letter, along with another letter written by the foreign minister of Iran that further implicated the Reagan team, was dismissed by the task force. Despite congressional task forces exonerating the Reagan team for what would have been high treason, allegations of an October surprise have continued to persist. A report by the Russian government confirmed it. Sources in the Israeli government did too, and so too did a former Reagan insider, Barbara Honegger. And in 1980, the former defense minister of Portugal claimed he had documents with proof of the October surprise that he would take to the United Nations. Unfortunately, he died shortly thereafter in a plane crash. So we can't know for sure what really happened behind the scenes in Washington and in Iran 34 years ago. But there's pretty good evidence to suggest something underhanded may have happened, which gave way to a truly transformative Reagan presidential administration. But hey, you don't have to take my word for it. Just take the former president of Iran's word for it. In Washington, D.C., Sam Sachs, RT.